The Standard Missile 3, SM-3, is one of the most advanced defensive interceptors ever built, designed to destroy ballistic missiles in space before they re-enter the atmosphere. Developed by Raytheon, it forms a vital part of the United States Navy's Aegis ballistic missile defense system and represents the exo-atmospheric layer of America's multi-tier missile shield. Unlike air defense interceptors that deal with low or mid-altitude threats, the SM-3 is a space interceptor, engineered to strike enemy missiles in the cold void hundreds of miles above Earth. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why SM-3 is U.S. military's long-range sniper bullet against incoming ballistic missiles. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The roots of the SM-3 lie in the Standard Missile family, originally developed for shipborne air defense. The SM-2 provided long-range fleet protection, and later the SM-6 added multi-role capabilities. The SM-3, however, took an entirely different evolutionary path. Instead of countering aircraft or cruise missiles, it was adapted to hunt ballistic missiles that soar into space before plunging back toward their targets. This shift required a completely new guidance, propulsion, and kill mechanism. The SM-3 was designed to be launched from Aegis-equipped ships using the same Mark 41 vertical launching system, VLS, that fires SM-2 and SM-6, but with a highly specialized warhead and upper stage. In essence, it gave naval fleets the power to intercept ballistic missiles far beyond the horizon and even beyond the atmosphere. The SM-3 is tightly integrated into the Aegis combat system, which provides the radar tracking, target discrimination, and fire control necessary for such precision engagements. In addition to U.S. Navy ships, Japan's Kongo and Maya-class destroyers, and soon South Korea's Sejong, the Great-class destroyers, will carry the SM-3. This interoperability allows allied navies to share tracking data and coordinate defense against ballistic missile attacks, effectively creating a distributed shield over the Pacific and European theaters. On land, Aegis ashore facilities replicate the same shipborne systems using static radar arrays and vertical launch modules. Together, these assets form part of the United States Layered Missile Defense Network alongside THAAD, Patriot PAC-3, and Ground-Based Interceptors, GBI, in Alaska and California. Once an Aegis ship's radar, such as the SPY-1 or the newer AN-SPY-6, detects an incoming ballistic missile, the fire control system predicts its trajectory and cues the SM-3 for launch. The missile's first two rocket stages propel it out of the atmosphere, while the third stage separates and releases the kinetic warhead, KW, a small, agile vehicle known as the lightweight exo-atmospheric projectile, LEAP. The LEAP doesn't carry explosives. Instead, it uses an advanced infrared seeker to track the target against the background of space, steering itself using a divert and attitude control system, DACS. At closing speeds exceeding Mach 10, even a small impact delivers enormous kinetic energy, enough to shatter a ballistic missile or its warhead into debris. This hit-to-kill mechanism is a defining feature of modern missile defense. It removes the need for a blast fragmentation warhead, making it more precise and effective even in the vacuum of space. A successful intercept is essentially a collision between two objects traveling thousands of meters per second, a feat requiring extraordinary precision. For most of its life, the SM-3 had only proven itself in tests, including the notable 2008 operation Burnt Frost, when the U.S. Navy used an SM-3 to shoot down a malfunctioning satellite orbiting at 150 miles, 240 kilometers altitude, a demonstration of its precision and power. However, April 2024 marked a turning point. U.S. Navy destroyers launched SM-3 interceptors in combat for the first time to neutralize Iranian ballistic missiles launched toward Israel. The successful engagement validated the system's readiness for real-world operations and demonstrated that sea-based interceptors can now provide regional ballistic missile defense in active conflict zones. Like the SM-6, the SM-3 has evolved through multiple variants known as blocks. Block 1A was the first operational version, providing reliable short and medium range ballistic missile interception. Block 1B introduced a two-color infrared seeker for better target discrimination and an upgraded DACS for improved agility. Block 2A, co-developed by Raytheon and Japan's Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, represents the most powerful evolution yet. It is larger in diameter, 0.54 meters compared to 0.34 meters in earlier versions, carries more propellant, and achieves much higher speeds. Up to Mach 14, this allows it to engage intermediate-range ballistic missiles at ranges exceeding 1,250 miles, about 2,000 kilometers, and altitudes of 620 miles, around 1,000 kilometers. The SM-3 Block 2A is the variant deployed in Aegis Ashore installations, fixed land-based sites in Romania and soon in Poland, forming NATO's ballistic missile defense architecture. These sites extend the reach of sea-based interceptors, providing 24/7 protection for Europe against potential missile threats from the Middle East. Building a missile that can destroy another missile in space is among the hardest problems in engineering. The SM-3 must distinguish a real warhead from decoys, track it across hundreds of kilometers, and maneuver precisely in microgravity. Each intercept requires synchronized input from satellite tracking systems, ship radars, and command networks. While immensely capable, the SM-3 also carries strategic implications. Its deployment in Europe and Asia has often drawn criticism from Russia and China, who argue it could undermine their nuclear deterrence. The U.S. source, however, maintains that the system is purely defensive, aimed at rogue state missile threats rather than great power arsenals. The SM-3 is more than a missile. It's a statement of technological confidence, proof that intercepting a ballistic missile in space is not only possible, but operationally achievable. From the deck of a destroyer or from a remote Aegis Ashore site, the SM-3 gives the United States and its allies a way to counter some of the most dangerous weapons on Earth, far from their intended targets. Where the SM-6 dominates the atmosphere and the SM-2 defends the fleet at long range, the SM-3 extends that defense into space, making it the true exo-atmospheric shield of the U.S. Navy. Raytheon and the Missile Defense Agency continue to refine the SM-3 with software and sensor upgrades. The Block 2A variant is now the main production model, but studies are underway for next-generation kill vehicles and multi-object kill capabilities, allowing a single interceptor to engage multiple warheads or decoys. As threats evolve, including hypersonic glide vehicles and maneuverable re-entry vehicles, the SM-3's role may expand from pure ballistic missile defense to part of a broader integrated missile shield, combined with faster radar processing and artificial intelligence-assisted targeting, the SM-3 could remain relevant well into the 2030s.